need to find the note, the note, the note. Shut up. Come on. This has been a long quarantine. Hello, welcome back to my channel. My name is Sam Scott-Thorne and I am a vocal coach based in Glasgow. Now, if you'd like to meet and explore your voice a little more, you can find me on sstvocals.com. You can also find me on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook and Patreon, and I'll put the handles down below and over there. Oh, I think I just got by that one by the skin of my teeth.
No.
Meh, just gonna have to do. So if you'd like to consider becoming a patron, you have access to things like early release of reactions, you can fast track reactions to become a reaction, there's vocal harmony breakdowns, there's all sorts of stuff, special access to my Discord group, so consider becoming a patron and help shape my channel. So this next one we're gonna do is a return to Leprous. Now this was actually the first suggestion that was put on my new Discord channel, which there's a link to down there. So I did Leprous once before. I haven't listened to them since. I was very impressed. I remember the guy's got like a really cool voice, and the music's kind of like trippy. So I'm excited to revisit. So let's just do it, shall we? Okay, so this is Leprous doing Acquired Taste live at Rockefeller Music Hall. Let's go. This is probably the same concert I watched the other time, but let's keep going. Let's go. Let's go. I love that kind of space age futuristic sound.
Dive deep into the subconscious layers. Be careful not to see. Stay out, be free. Don't enter this abyss. That's where I go to think.
Right, okay, so first things first. Can't speak today. First things first, the music itself is really cool. Like, I'm enjoying the kind of futuristic boom, 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 boom sounds. Gives it a lot of space. And then it's got this kind of like, almost like a 90s grunge kind of raw rock sound to it. So those two things that don't really sit together have blended to form this really cool sound. Onto our friend on the vocals. Just class. Like, I love the way that he places phrases in between kind of time frames, so it sounds really interesting. There's a lot of sob in his voice, so there's like cries, that kind of sound. Not like that, obviously, but what he's doing is he's pushing his vocal and then allowing that sound to kind of glide on the top of notes. It just makes this really kind of cool, it's a cry kind of sound. Love it. Let's keep going.
Enjoy the restrictions. Be glad you can feel this thing. Silent.
Can you hear it?
Compassion.
Glosses over the top of every note.
Do anything.
Yes. Hear how little force he's giving this. Like, all of that volume and that note is just happening really, really easily. He's not putting any extra pressure on himself, and it's flying out of his mouth. Just absolutely beautiful. I love that half of that chorus had zero lyrics at all. I think I remember saying this the last time, but this music is so oddly relaxing. Like, I just kind of zone out and go to like a really good place when I listen to Leprous for some reason. Anyway, really, really good. I am absolutely loving the just the ease of it all. It's beautiful. Yes. Is here how he added an H sound and a cry onto that phrase? Ah, 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 so you can add that cry into the middle of that note. Really nice. I just love that sound. It's like he's pleading every time he sings. It's amazing. Authentic falsetto. Lovely.
Control of it all. That's where you're thinking. As if you can pull an end to this. Rest now, tomorrow. You can make it all. Okay, prepare a day you will not miss. Bring forth your gift. Yeah, yeah. Made from pure belief. Be sure no one finds out. Be sure no one finds out.
What? Right. There's so much going on here. He's absolutely moulding his vocal around the movement of this song. He's finding any little space he can, and he's adding in like a little touch of tone here, a different texture there, dropping the larynx here, some fry there, a cry there, a touch of falsetto. Finding the space and just occupying it beautifully. It's like it's poetry in not motion. Poetry in audible sounds. Oh, I was better describing it than, you know, summing it up. Anyway, just absolutely wonderful. He's just got such a good command. Oh, there's something different happening. You buttoning up your shirt. Is that a baby girl? Aha! I know that's the big build up. I could listen to him doing just that the whole time. Now, it doesn't sound like much. Like, to the average person, like, he's just singing aha over and over and over again. But there's so much going on. So he's going from straight note to straight note, and straight note to straight onto a vibrato, straight note onto full vibrato, straight note onto split cry vibrato, straight note, split note vibrato falsetto. Like, it's just incredible. That build is so beautiful. What are we dealing with? Oh. I'm probably doing that wrong. Or whatever it was, I don't know. The first time I've heard it, so give us a bit of space. But amazing, just so good. Oh, it's doing it again. Wow. Oh my god, this is just crazy. So that part there was full head voice. Now, a lot of folk say head voice falsetto, same thing. In my opinion, they are not. You'll probably get differing accounts depending on which vocal person you speak to. But for me, a head voice is connected to the range of your voice. That's head voice, because I can pull up and down from my chest. Whereas falsetto, your folds, they tilt and there's air coming through at the same time. Hootie. And you can't bring that down. Eventually it's just going to run out. There's no more steam to it because you can't sustain that the whole way down. So that to me was head voice. But then he went into falsetto for the second part. And props to the guy that's singing with him, because he's matching those little intricate sounds as well. They obviously work really well together as a band in general, but just a shout out to them too. To him and him. Him and him. Thank you. Thank you. That was insane. There was parts there as he went back into his last chorus where he was properly just doing full on flips. So like a full chest sound into a falsetto flip, but he just never really let the falsetto go anywhere. So it had that kind of cry element to it, but it was a lot more pronounced. You heard this kind of, a real kind of change in the placement of that sound. This guy is insanely talented. Like, one of my favorite voices, I think. It's just like a rallying cry to battle. I don't even know, but I would fight for you. I would fight for him. Amazing. Just so, so good. So I hope you liked that reaction. If you did, please give it a like and a thumbs up down below. And if you want to see more from me, hit subscribe. Ring the bell, and anytime I have new content, you will be the first to know. You will. Yes. Is that not the sentence? That's the sentence. So I guess all that's left for me to say is thank you so much for joining me. And how are we going to buy this one? Bye, 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 bye. I hope that was the right note. It probably wasn't, but bye.